Hey, what's going on, everyone? Welcome back to another video. Today we're going to take a look at the Disney Plus wave, Falcon and Winter Soldier, WandaVision, and Loki action figures. Let's go ahead and pop these guys open.
You have proved that you fight well. Now you can join us.
And here are the Disney Plus wave figures out of the packaging. And I really do like this wave. All of the shows are doing really well. Loki just came out last Wednesday, so I am really happy that I found this wave. So this morning around 9 o'clock, I got dressed and shot down to Walmart to pick up some groceries. And lucky me, they actually had some shelves stocked. They did have mostly the Shang-Chi wave up there, but they did just get a full case of the Winter Soldier, of the whole Disney Plus wave. So I went ahead and picked up the ones I wanted. I didn't pick up Vision and I didn't pick up Captain America, Sam. For the moment, just I don't really want that Vision. I will pick it up at a certain point, but I have no desire for that one right now. And the Sam Wilson, I have the comic book version and he's 2 per case, so I wasn't really eager to pick up that figure. But as far as these figures go, I really did want to pick them up and take a look and mess around with them. So with that being said, let's just go ahead and take a look at them one by one. Alright, so first up, let's take a real quick look at Wanda. I think this figure looks really good. I think the packaging looks really good as well. Wanda Maximoff's ability of telekinesis, energy manipulation, and neuroelectronic interfacing allows her to read thoughts and give targets waking nightmares. So, if you haven't seen the show already, it was a pretty good show. I really did like it. It had aspects to Marvel that the movies haven't done yet. I really did like it. I liked the way that it ended. It really leads into the next movies coming out really well, and I really did enjoy the show. But let's go ahead and just talk about the figure. Out the box, I really wanted this figure for her costume. I think it looks great, and my favorite thing is that it didn't come with heels. It just came with the regular boots. And I like the fact that the jacket goes down all the way to the boots, but it's not a jacket, it's just kind of like her skirt thing. I don't know exactly what you would call that. She comes with those effects on around her arms, which is pretty cool. And then she also does come with alternate hands. One weird thing is this hand, this casting hand, which this one is too, the hinge only goes up and down. So you can't really go make it as if she's like blasting somebody away, unless you're using her right hand. So the left hand only goes left and right, like a trigger hand. But this one, you could cast a spell. So that's really my only gripe with that figure. Another cool thing would have been an alternate head. This hair sculpt kind of has like a whoosh to it, kind of like it's blowing away. So it's not very casual or anything. So she's like constantly casting a spell. Those are really my only gripes about this figure. I'm not going to go into too much detail of the articulation. Besides that, the aesthetics look great. I think it looks just like the actress. Yeah, this is a great figure. I'm going to go ahead and move on to Loki. And next up, we have the TVA variant Loki. And this is a really cool suited body. It's just, you know, kind of like a basic figure. He came with no accessories, but he did come with all the flight gear for Captain America in the packaging. Other than that, he came with no accessories, so it's just kind of a bare bones figure. I do like this figure. I did want it for some photography things, but I'm not too happy with the head sculpt. You know, he just kind of has that smirk on his face and his hair is kind of blowing in the wind. So over on this side, you have, you know, kind of like a casual hair, but over on this side, you have sloppy hair in the wind. So I think that's kind of, it's cool, but we should have got an alternate head with this one. I do like this figure. I do like the show. We're only on episode 1 so far. I really do like it. I also do have the Morbius figure on pre-order from Target. Owen Wilson, pretty excited to have that figure. So having that figure on pre-order, I definitely had to pick this figure up. And I'm pretty happy with it. The aesthetics are pretty basic. Black shoes, brown pants, blue shirt, brown collar, brown jacket, tan jacket. So it's just basically another everyday guy. This is a really good suited body for, you know, just background characters, just somebody in the streets. Anyways, these are just really quick reviews. I'm just kind of going over the aesthetics and what I think of these figures. Let's go ahead and dive into Falcon Winter Soldier. Baron Zemo, the Sokovian Special Forces officer who targeted the Avengers, has been rotting in a German prison, but recent events will reignite him with ferocity. So here's Baron Zemo out of the packaging, and I'm really happy I picked up this figure. I think it came out really great. It looks like a really cool casual figure, but the head sculpt came out really good. I think it looks just like the actor. Really, really cool head sculpts. I think the jacket looks really good. The coating around his neck looks really great. The red on his shirt looks good. Going down, he just has the casual pants and then the business shoes. Going up, the jacket looks really good. The jacket is a harder plastic, so that kind of blows, but it is poseable. You are able to do things with this guy. He is very basic. Other than what you see in front of you, he came with two fists. He comes with the book that has the Winter Soldier codes inside of it. He comes with his masked alternate head, which looks really good, pretty accurate to the show. And he also comes with a golden handgun, which I think looks pretty good, actually. Let's go ahead and move on. After being stripped of his Captain America title, John F. Walker's spirit is shaken, and he takes a new mantle, U.S. Agent. So here we have U.S. Agent out of the packaging, and I actually really like the way this uniform looks. I do wish it had that white stripe like it has in the back of the packaging, but this version is screen accurate. I was actually watching the show this morning before I went to Walmart and found the figures. So it's kind of ironic that I found them today. I do like this costume. One unfortunate thing is he doesn't come with a shield. What's up with that? They could have at least thrown in like the crappy shield that he made at the end. But right now I have him holding just a simple shield that came with the Skeleton Knights. And he's holding his gun, which doesn't come out of the holster right there. Other than that, I think the uniform came out really good. I really like the star that's on his chest right there. And I actually think the head sculpt came out really good. The side profile on it actually looks pretty awesome. I have seen some people repaint the deco on his chest into white. And I think that looks pretty good, but I'm probably going to just leave it as is because I have a lot of figures to open. And I still have a lot of videos I want to do. So besides that, I really do like this figure. I think the aesthetics came out pretty accurate to the show. He's mostly black, red, and blue, and his outfit is actually screen accurate to the show. So I'm pretty happy with this figure, and the articulation ain't too bad. So let's go ahead and take a look at Winter Soldier. And here is Bucky Barnes, aka the Winter Soldier. Thrusted back into the real world, Bucky is forced to figure out how to become James Barnes again, all while facing demons from his past. So if you haven't seen the show already, Bucky is kind of dealing with living in the future as a normal person, and he's kind of dealing with things from the past, and he doesn't have any friends, you know, because Steve is gone. So that's his whole bit. I think this figure came out really good. I think the head sculpt is actually pretty spot on, but I do have some gripes with this figure, and I do have some things I really love about this figure. One being the head sculpt. The head sculpt came out really, really great. They probably used that 3D material. The vibranium arm came out really, really cool. I really like the texture on it. The feel of it is really cool. It has that really nice shine on it. You can kind of see the gold and the black right there. The chest came out really cool. I really like that. I think the whole upper body on him came out really good. I think the blue came out really good on there. The only thing is the legs. Why is the thigh swivel all the way just like right above the knee? And then I just feel like he's so thin on the bottom. I'm definitely going to put some more stuff on this figure, kind of bulk him up, make him look a little buffer. But it is a good aesthetic figure. It does look really good. I do feel like it's lacking in a few things. Like, I wish they put in the neck. I wish they put the neck the G.I. Joe figures have on this figure. For some reason, he cannot look down at all. He can look up just fine, but he cannot look down. And just the range of his neck and the head kind of sucks. It seems very limited. If they gave him the G.I. Joe necks, I mean, that would just solve all the problems. I mean, even the Power Ranger figures are adapting that. So, I mean, Marvel Legends has the money. They definitely have a lot of money now. So I wish they wouldn't go cheap on figures. But again, I do feel like this figure is 50-50. Aesthetically, he looks amazing. But we didn't get as much articulation as we could have on this figure. So let's go ahead and take a look at all the figures again, and then, yeah.
It's someone else's. It isn't.
Alright guys, so taking a look at all the figures again, I really do like this wave. I really do like the shows. Loki just came out last Wednesday. I like the direction of the show. Spoilers, they did say that they were hunting Loki, and they want to use Loki to hunt Loki, which is pretty cool. But the villain at the end looks nothing like Loki. It actually looked like a female. So I think that's really interesting, and I think that show is going to be really, really good. If you saw one snippet at the when Loki saw himself die, there was a snippet of 615 and 616, and 616 is the definitive timeline for Marvel Comics. So I really hope by the end of the show they have some sort of like new timeline going on, and shit, I just hope they introduce the X-Men. Honestly, I hope we get mutants somehow out of that show. But anyways, I hope you guys liked this really, really quick review. I didn't want to get into it and have this video be too long. I definitely wanted to take a look at these figures one by one. I definitely wanted to open them up instead of waiting a whole month to get to each figure individually. So that's my reason behind this video. Anyways, if you guys haven't already, please do subscribe. It really does help me out. Leave a comment down below. Let me know what your favorite Disney Plus Marvel show is. Let me know what type of theories you guys have for the Loki show. I'm really interested in all that. So thank you guys for checking out this video. Like I said, if you haven't subscribed already, please do. You can find me on Instagram at OdinFiguration, or you can find me on Facebook at OdinFiguration. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace.